Nomad Sculpt 2.1 has a few more surprises for us. These are hierarchy lines. Now, these are a physical representation that are linked to the hierarchy in the scene menu. It shows you how everything is tied together. We're going to go into two different models, one that has them and one that does not, and I'm going to show you how to put them in. All right, let's get into it. All right, so we're going to come into the scene menu, and we're going to loot this sphere. We don't really need that. We're going to go over to the folder and hit the preset button. Now, for this, let's go and grab one of the posables. So this is not going to work for the hierarchy lines if we're not looking at the posable. So let's just grab the posable male, add to the scene. All right, so now you have a posable male. If you guys didn't see this before, I was showing you guys what this was all about. And it automatically hooks the pelvis, and that's the center of the body. Because if you pick the stomach, it goes down, one of the legs comes up. And that's kind of how the regular hierarchy works. But let's take a look, closer look. So we come into the same menu. As you can see, this is all divided up and all the lines. Now, if this is a little confusing, this is quite a bit because you have so many different parts of the body in here connected. But the main part is how they are in these long lines, how they're divided up. And you'll notice that the pelvis is the top of the chain. And as it comes down, it goes to each individual part. So then the shoulders, say that's the first part of the shoulder, first part of the leg. So I want to show you something super cool about this now, though. Let's shrink all this. Now, if you want to see actually how this is all tied together, we have something new in here now. Go in advanced, go down where it says hierarchy lines, click on this. Now, I've changed the color. It's normally going to be gray like this. I think it's a little bit easier to see on the screen. So let's go back up and change this a little bit again. Leave it there. You hit the little circle, it'll go back for you. All right. So now you can see that this is the pelvis, and it goes right there where you can see at that junction between the legs and the body. If you go up to the here, it looks the same, but it's gonna still pick the top of that. And if you grab here, it grabs everything. And then down here, grab a leg. Now you notice one other thing that's interesting. You'll notice where this pivot point is connected to the hip. And right at that break in the line is, so you, that's where you know where the pivots are. So if you come up here, you'll see the same thing between the bicep and the forearm, that the forearm connection is right at that bend, and then the shoulder is going to be at that point. So that's kind of showing you where all the pivot points are, where those breaks are. Now, the other thing I want you to notice about the hierarchy lines is from the pelvis, the arrows go up and out, and at the bottom it goes the other way down each leg, all the way down to the toes, and then all the way to the fingers as well for the upper body. And then same thing for the head, because if you grab the head, everything's going to go with the ears. Let's see. I think it's has separate ears, has several different sections for the eyelids, for the eyes, nose, and even the bridge is all separate. But that's all tied together where it goes. You know, you can change the nose itself, but if you grab the head, they all come together because of where the hierarchy lines are. Now I'm going to show you how to fix one if you haven't built it in, or if it's one, there is one particular one in here that is not set up that way. So let's go back into the folder, grab the preset again. Now we're going to come up to the realistic skull, click on it, add it to the scene. Yes. Now you notice that this guy is all tied together. We go into the scene, it's one piece. Now you have two options of how to fix this. You can go up to separate right here and it'll separate them all. Or you can come down on this line with the actual article you're messing with and hit separate. Either one of those is gonna make it happen. Okay, now let's look at this. You can see how the hierarchy lines start at the center, like right here. If you grab it, even though that's at the top, and the arrow is going to the top up there. Everything's all in one line. So for hierarchy sake, that's not going to work. So I know that 17 down is the bottom teeth, and we need to unselect the skull too. So you can see that if we zoom in, that is all the teeth on the bottom. Because if we grab this instead and we try to move the jaw, you can see that he gets a heck of a toothache because all his teeth are gone. So to fix that, we're going to unclick this. We can go ahead and click this and change the name to jaw or mandible if you want to be super particular. And then let's see, unselect that. We're going to come down to 17, go all the way down. All right, so that's all the teeth. Now let's come up to add group, and we're going to rename this group bottom teeth. And you really want to keep this straight, because if you don't, you're going to have a real issue with trying to keep everything straight and organized here in just a second. So bottom teeth are good. Now, got the jaw. We're going to name the skull. And you'll see in a little bit that this is all going to make a big difference here soon. All right, so we're going to grab the rest of the teeth. So you see that's all the upper teeth there, all outlined. So you can see them all. And you'll see already that the bottom, when we put them in a group, it already made a hierarchy that was making sense for all the teeth together. All right, so we're going to add another group. We're going to name these upper teeth. And like I said, it's important to keep these together, and you'll see in just a second. It can get really confusing very quickly. So you get upper teeth, bottom teeth. All right, now we're going to pull the jaw off, pull it all the way out, and we're going to put it in between right here. Pull the teeth here. All right, so we're getting closer. Now you can see we have the hierarchy lines have changed again. So if we grab the skull, we'll see if everything's working. And that's still not what we want yet. But let's look at the lower jaw, and it's better. But you can see the pivots where, so let's go ahead and fix that while we're here. Click on the right, on your right cube there, or the other the ball, whichever one you have to use. Click on the pivot, and now you see that the pivot gizmo grays out and grab up, and notice what's happening to the hierarchy lines. They're moving with the pivot. Okay, click on the pivot again, and we're done. Now, when we move the jaw, everything moves like it should. Okay. Now, with the skull, now we need to change this. First of all, here, we can get rid of this grouping. That was the original grouping. We no longer need that, so we can just get rid of that. Now, the upper teeth need to be attached to the skull, and the jaw needs to be attached here, like so. Now, if we grab the skull, everything moves together. And if we grab the lower jaw, everything works. Grab the skull, everything moves together. So that has fixed all of our hierarchy lines. Now, I'm going to show you one more thing, and this is where it can get very confusing, because you need to know where to put everything. So we're going to add one more thing to this. So let me click back and just get him straight again. We're going to come to the front view, and we'll just do like almost like a medical skull and cut the top. So let's grab the top of him. We're going to grab split, rectangle, and let's chop them about right there. Okay, now when you look at this, you can see that the hierarchy lines are got some weird things going on. And you see that you have almost a loop in there. You got the teeth from the upper teeth to the skull cap, back down to the jaw, to the lower teeth. That's not going to work quite right. So if we use the upper one, if we just grab you can see there's something weird going on. Grab the skull. He does. Now everything's all weird again. Let's go back here and fix everything. Now the skull split, we need to make sure we have everything correct. So you'll see that the skull split is the actual bottom of the skull. So let's rename that so we can keep everything straight. And this is the part where it can be a little confusing if you don't rename everything. So you need to check which one is which. And this is no longer the skull. This is the skull cap. Okay, so we need to pull the skull cap off. To do that, you have to pull everything else below. If you try to pull the skull cap like this, then it grabs everything. We don't want that. So what we want to do is grab upper teeth and pull it off of there, pull it off of everything. Okay. And then you got to pull the jaw down. All right. So it's a little confusing. It's just how you have to work all of the hierarchy lines. All right. So skull bottom is the main part that we want everything to always go with the skull bottom. It stays at the top. Skull cap can go all the way down at the bottom. And now we can start fixing everything. So the skull, the upper teeth can go to the skull. And I guess we should probably name this, make this a little, make a little more sense. Main, skull main maybe would make more sense. Skull main. Okay. Upper teeth. Now the jaw can go just like this. And that should all work. And then the skull cap should come down here like this. Now you'll notice that from the skull, from the center of that point, everything's going out. So everything should work. So the one for the upper skull, the arrow is going up to it. And then down here, going down to the jaw and the teeth on it, the lower part of the skull is all going down. So if we're on the main part of the skull, everything's good. We go to the jaw, we're good here. And we go to the skull cap, we can move it separately. Now, if you want to get a little fancier, we can grab the pivot again on this one, move it over so it's right at the back. And this is where you can really notice, as soon as I let go of this, watch where the hierarchy line goes, snaps right to your gizmo. So now, when I hit the pivot, now I can pivot it from the back, grab the jaw, open it up, and mind blown. All right, so I hope this really helps with hierarchy lines. It's a really cool new feature in here. It really helps you make an understand if you have everything properly aligned. You basically pick the one part in your hierarchy that you want everything to follow. So in this case, it's the main part of the skull. The top of the skull and the jaw are lower parts of that. And if you look at here, it comes straight down to the skull cap on its own. The jaw and the upper teeth are all part of the main skull, and it just kind of steps down like this to the right. And that's just how you have to separate it. So just remember now with the hierarchy lines, those arrows give you the indication along with the lines where you're going and where your pivots are. Hey, if you found anything useful in this video, please like and subscribe, and I will see you next time. All right, thanks.